Check.
Check 1, 2. Wait, is it working?
Thank you.
Let everyone say, amen. What wondrous love is this? Oh, my soul, oh, my soul. I love the traditional and the contemporary arrangements of that. Thank you, T. Welcome in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and on behalf of the mission and ministry of the Hawkinsville First United Methodist Church. Welcome. Welcome those here in person and those that are online and faithfully watching, those that who could not be here for various reasons and those that are away and out of town. We welcome each of you. What a glorious day. We've been given such a wonderful taste of fall these last few days. And what a glorious time. So let us go to God as we offer our hearts in worship. Will you pray with me? Almighty and eternal loving Heavenly Father, your grace is sufficient for every need in this room and in our lives, and those of our family and friends and community and those who would call strangers. Lord, your grace is sufficient. Let us pour out our hearts of thankfulness of how we love you because you poured out that grace through the cross of Calvary. Accept our hearts and our communal gathering together as a community of faith to worship and praise you. We do this all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen and amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, to all of those that Christy said, welcome, I'm not going to repeat it. There's no point. Okay, you got it. But we are glad you're here today. A beautiful crowd, beautiful faces. It's awesome to see the Methodist spirit still alive. Amen. The first thing I would like to acknowledge is the flowers this morning. They are given to the glory of God and also in memory of Judy Jones. As you know, by the Jones family, Judy died and had her services this week. And we keep their family in our hearts and prayers. First of all, J.D., good morning. You didn't expect that one, did you? We have the first Sunday morning with a new class. How did it go? Congratulations to you. Be sure and talk to Joel Garrett. He's asked about it 4 or 5 times. He doesn't remember it, but he did. Would like to remind you that we will have a Wednesday night meal. And I'm going to tell you chicken fingers, and you can read all the rest of it. But J.D. and Jamie are our servers that night. So you can hand out your cards to the class, all right? If you are a visitor this morning, we welcome you, and we will ask if you will, please use the visitor's card that's in the pew and put in the offering plate when it goes by. We'd like to know more about you. Because of the holidays, we've got several things that are not going to meet. The BGs will not meet tonight. However, the church council will meet tonight. And if you're on the church council, please be in attendance. The council, I think it's at 6 o'clock, isn't it? 5 o'clock. All right. But they will be meeting. The youth will not be meeting tonight. Let's see. Church Council, the UWF will hold their regular meetings tomorrow at 2 p.m. I've got glasses hanging on my neck, and why I'm not using them, I don't know. The Methodist men will not be meeting in the morning. Did someone else have something to contribute?
Put your glasses on.
Oh. She's worse than my mother.
Because I love you.
I know that's right. Let's see. Today is the 13th of October. Asa Cootie has a birthday today. Joshua Coffey. Michaela Jones has a birthday on Thursday. And that is it for the week. I know Harley had a whole pile of them last week, but that's it for the week. So if you're, anybody else got a birthday? Lexi Pritchard had a birthday Wednesday.
Ed's got something back there.
Early voting starts Tuesday with Ed. Be sure this time, please vote, and please vote your convictions. Where's Levi? There's Levi. Levi got his first deer last night, a four-pointer. And it was with a bow and arrow. What am I looking at you? Why? Oh, we're very proud of him. Does anybody else have any concerns or anything that I have omitted? Please look at the prayer concerns. We are starting to have several, and many of our congregations, congregation is unfortunately very sick, so please keep them in your prayers. If nobody else has got anything to say, so that I can shut up, please stand as we sing 170, Oh How I Love Jesus. Apostles' Creed is in your bulletin. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, who died, Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. the third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Glory be to the Father.
Those moments that everybody loves. Greet somebody. Tell them hello.
Good morning again. Good morning. Our prayers go out to everyone. I just want to say a great Thanksgiving for several things, and here it goes. Thank you all who spent the time praying for those, in particular for my dad and me, who were in the throes of Hurricane Milton, and we came out very well, comparatively to a lot of folks just around us. So everything is okay, and we never lost power. It was just miraculous. So thank you for your prayers. Thank you what you did for the Jones family. From the choir to the hospitality to the joy class, serve them with grace and love. And thank you for the outpouring of your presence and your prayers, and continue. We also know that another member passed away, that is Miss May Gentry, and I'm sure most of you have heard that she had died, and that there will be a service of some sort and arrangements coming forth. I will be meeting with the family sometime early in the week. So we will make sure you know those arrangements for the Gentry family and in honor and in celebration of her life. There are others that we need to continue to pray for. Don't forget Bill and Amy and many others. If I had a show of hands, I imagine you're with me, that you have many just private or silent prayer requests. Yeah. And so we want to honor that they don't need a lot of public notoriety. I want to just thank you all for surrounding the community in times of need. David and Stephanie and your children are to be commended for inspiring us to gather items. We have gathered items now for over a week, and several flights have taken place. At least one more angel flight will take place, if not two, and distribute those in still the areas. I have a friend in Douglas, Georgia. You may know her. She's very well known in the conference. Allison Lindsay and her husband, Griff, and they have some grandchildren, and the adult children are not there. They've been out of power for 17 days in Douglas, Georgia, just near us. So let's pray together that everyone continues to get back to some new normal that they can do. Will you pray with me? Father God, we, as a congregation, we have felt the losses through death. We have also felt the inspiration through life and birth that you've given, and revival birth that you're giving individuals that will spill over to the life of the Hawkinsville First United Methodist Church. Glory be to you, God, of the comfort and peace that you give us and these families and friends in their times of need, and the legacy of love and celebration that you provide through their lives. We thank you that we can come together and prepare for the upcoming year. 2025 is going to be here before we know it. We need to finish out well and finish the race of 2024. But Lord, be with us as our church council begins to look at the preparations and the nuances. And you author every bit of that, Lord. Heavenly Father, we lift up those continuing to need physical, emotional, mental, spiritual, and relational healing. Our land is in such a place, almost like the Israelites of old. Forgive us of our sins and free us to truly repent and not repeat. Truly repent and not repeat. So it's in the name of Jesus. We lift our hearts, the silent needs that lay before you, and our hearts and lives that go to live as disciples, loving you. For it's in the name of Jesus, I offer this our prayer, and that we pray together that faithful prayer that Jesus taught his disciples and that we have as a model prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
We now invite our acolytes and ushers to come receive our morning offerings. Our Heavenly Father, please take our gift. Use it for the betterment of your kingdom. These things we ask in your name. Amen.
ask the children if they'll come join me. Miss Kara is taking a well-deserved time away. Let me scoot by you. Okay, here you go. Okay, don't open and eat until after your lunch. Don't open or eat it until after your lunch. Promise? Promise? Okay. Wow. Did I miss somebody? Did I miss somebody? Oh my goodness. Well, that's okay. She didn't need or deserve it. Our text says to do three things. You got to act justly. You got to love mercy. And you got to walk humbly with God. Now, did I just act justly? Did I? No. Did I do the right thing? She said, yes. Yeah. Did I really do the right thing? No. Now, I don't eat until after lunch, okay? Oh, look. It's doing the right thing. Y'all, sometimes it's not easy or fun to do the right thing. But you know right from wrong, don't you, already? Even as young as you are, you know right from wrong. So let's always do the right thing, or somebody's going to get overlooked. And we don't want that. Because Jesus didn't do the right thing for the cross of Calvary for us so that we would be overlooked. He died for us. Amen. So do justice is a big phrase saying, just do the right thing all the time. Tell the truth, even if it gets you in trouble, okay? And love, even though you may have to have the consequence of what you've done if you didn't do the right thing. See, guess what? I would have had to live with that for the whole time I was here at Hawkinsville. I didn't want to do that, so I may just give her another one. No. All right. So what are we going to do? Y'all say it together. Do. There you go. Let's pray. Repeat after me. Dear Jesus, it's hard sometimes to do the right thing. But it is what I'm supposed to do. To love you. In Jesus' name, I love you, Lord. Amen. All right. Y'all enjoy that for dessert. They'll be eaten before they leave.
Troubled surround us, when evils come, the body grows weak, and the spirit grows numb. When these things beset, forget us. He sends us his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his is pure, sweet love, a sign from above,
a sign from above,
on the wings of a dove,
on the wings of a dove.
When Jesus went down to the waters that day, he was baptized in the usual way. When it was done, God blessed his son. He sent him his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow-white dove. He sends his pure, sweet love, a sign from above,
a sign from above.
Amen. Trip and T, thank you so very, very much. Jesus showed his love. And now, as disciples of Jesus Christ, we now are commanded to show love back to Jesus by loving one another and by being disciples and growing in discipleship. Hear the words from the prophet Micah. Micah chapter 6, verses 6 through 8. It begins with, "What shall I come? What shall I come before the Lord? And bow down before the exalted God? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with 10,000s of rivers of olive oil? Shall I offer my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body and the sin of my soul? He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you but to do justice and love mercy and walk humbly with your God?" Let us pray. Come, Holy Spirit, and fill the hearts of these your faithful. Kindle in us the all-consuming and eternal fire of your everlasting love. And may it consume us so that we love one another and love others that may not always be lovable. For you have loved us when we were not lovable. Open up your word through your prophet Micah. This day, these familiar words, may they become new and refreshed in our spirit. And may our disciple walk grow just a little closer in obedience and following you. For it's in the name of Jesus Christ that we have now heard these, the words of our prophet through the God that we so serve. And these are the words of God for the people of God and let our response be, thanks be to God. In Jesus' precious name, amen and amen. Requirements are throughout our whole life. I want to tell from the youngest to the oldest here that there are requirements throughout our lives. You all that are in the seasoned year of the twilight years that we call have experienced requirements throughout and continue. There are requirements in Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid, and there are requirements that you must do in your older age in order to protect your property from being taken to care of you while you're being taken from you while you're being cared for. There are requirements all along. We have academic requirements for school. You have to do so much and you pass so much and you take so many classes and then you get the degree. We used to do homework at home, y'all. Sometimes the dog ate it. Yeah. When it was to be turned in the next day, oh no, my dog ate it. And some people didn't even have a dog. Requirements. I remember looking at the requirements for ordination. And I was like, Lowry, I was like, there is no way. But step by step, little by little, the requirements are there for a reason. To grow us and put an edge and growing edge on us. That we would not stay the same, but we would improve, we would increase, and that we would be better than we were the moment before. Requirements are there for civic organizations. There's the Lions Club. There used to be the Pilot Club. There's the Rotary International. Requirements of meetings that you have to attend. Money that you have to pay. You can't get by without that. And so the Israelites thought in their lives, what are we going to do? And the prophet Micah is just going off on them from chapter 1 to chapter 8. And he is just going and saying, you have committed the disobedience. You are not worthy. God is going to, and this is what God says, that he's going to punish you. You've got to be and hold up to the consequences. And they're going, wait a minute. What are the requirements? What are we to do? Aren't we to give the offering? That's what we learned in the Torah. That's what we learned in the tradition. That's what we learned in our lives, that the offering of the first and to give the first of that, our firstborn, our first fruits of our lives, our first of everything to God. God said, that's not what I want. Christy's paraphrase. That's not what I desire. That's not what I require or expect. And this is what I do. If you're going to be a disciple of Jesus Christ, who came some 100 years later than the prophet Micah recorded this, you're going to have to do this. Do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. We've heard it. In fact, we can quote it, but have we really adhered to that? Discipleship. We don't really like to hear that we got a responsibility now. It didn't just end at the commitment and the covenant we made before God and one another at the altar in which we said, we will support the Hawkinsville United Methodist Church with our prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness. It didn't end there. Y'all, it doesn't end at this altar. It just begins to get out into the world. Discipleship is a life expression of love to Jesus. Discipleship in a day and time where right and wrong is right is wrong, and wrong is right is very challenging. Let me say that again. Discipleship in a day where it seems that right is wrong and wrong is right is very challenging. And we find ourselves wondering, how am I going to walk in the will of God? and with God. As I explained to the kids, do the right thing. Doing justice, one of the complaints that people have with Mother Teresa was that she was not an advocate for our justice ministry. She had the epitome of being the most wonderful care person and giving dignity to death for those who are on the fringe and those who were not cared for in Calcutta, India. But she was accused that she should have gone further. She should have done something about the injustices that caused them to be in the ditches, in the streets, and that they were in such deluge and harm. To do justice. One of my dear friends in Marshallville, where I served in 2010 to 2014, Shelley Turner says, "My daddy always taught me, do the right thing." Church, do we always do the right thing? Do we even try to do the right thing? Are we all about us and all about me and my and what I can get? I've got the best idea. I've got the market on this, and I'm coming in. I'm brand new, and I'm going to tell you how to do church. Y'all been doing church for almost 200 years. Do the right thing. Maybe there's a more smoother way or little things that need to be tweaked. But we can do the right thing. And going about it in a loving manner that everybody is included and understands. Do justice. One of my passions from my heart, and God has not released and opened up those opportunities. Maybe I just have not recognized them. But I want to be an advocate for those injustices are just not right. I want God to place one cause before me. Before I take my last breath, I want God to show me how to correct the injustices that He points me to. I've been overseas. I've been to other places and other cultures. I've been in the bush and I've been in the villages. I've been in the places where you and I would not even survive a day. Where you have a hole in the ground, if you're lucky, that you can go and you can go to the bathroom. Where you have no showers for days. Some of you in the military understand and you get it. But to do justice, do the right thing. Love mercy. How many of y'all played that mercy game as kids? Y'all tell your age then. Yeah. I had a 5'11" and a 6'1" brother, and playing mercy with a 5-foot, well, I was 5 foot at that time. Anyway, 5-foot sister, that was not a fair game. Y'all, this is where you get your fingers entwined in others that's younger, those who don't know what the mercy game is, and you pour out and you try. It's kind of like almost arm wrestling until the other person says mercy. It's like wrestling until somebody says, "Uncle." We desire mercy. We want mercy because mercy is not getting what we deserve. Whereas grace is God giving us what we don't deserve. But mercy is not getting and not receiving what we deserve. We deserve the punishment of sin and death. That we ignore things and let it go by. We ignore people and let them go by. Love mercy. We cry out mercy. We cry out mercy. How many times did I cry out mercy? And we cry out mercy, but we're not willing to give mercy. Church. And walk humbly with God. I give thanks and praise to Miss Betty Hotchkiss, who lived in Marshallville at the time I did. She worked for the Pearson Peach Pecan, and she was over all of the management of the mail orders. They moved to Gray in retirement, and she and her husband have beautiful 40 acres of land, now demolished trees all around them, thanks to Hurricane Helene, but they still keep in touch. I thank God for Betty because she did something for me, and she helped me continue that for several appointments. She came over one day to the parsonage. They lived right across the street from the church, right across from the parsonage. She said, "Hey, I need a walking partner. I needed somebody to hold me accountable." And I said, "Well, I do too." And so we would get up at 5 and 6 o'clock in the morning and walk about a mile to 2 miles, sometimes three. And then she would go to work, and I would pretend I was working at the church. Anyway, that was, you can laugh, that's fine. And then I moved 4 years after that. They lived there for another couple years, and then they retired in Gray. And then I got walking partners in Wiggum. And actually, I had walking partners in Adel. Out in the country at the Antioch Church, we could walk around there, and it was so safe and so secure. And then in Wiggum, and then in Cairo, had walking partners. And so I just relished that. Somehow I let that go in Waycross, and I have not picked it back up in Hawkinsville. But yet, it's walking with somebody, talking, caring. I got to listen to her life story. I got to know about her parents, and I got to know about her childhood. I got to know Betty more and more. When we get walking humbly with God, we get to know Him more in the morning, in the cool of the morning, in the cool of the evening, in the afternoon's heat. We can walk humbly with God. But pride has been the greatest sin that we need to repent of, church, individually and corporately, that the pride has come upon the church, and that pride is me. Pride is what I've done. Look at what I'm doing. Look at how I have impacted. Well, I want you to know, if you've at least received one of the Facebook pages posts, that there is a myriad of eyes going out there, and it's called a team that has gone and helped others that literally have no electricity, no water, nothing. Some of them do not have their houses from Hurricane Helene. And then got impacted with some of the aftermath of Hurricane Milton. But you all, pride won't let that happen. Because pride says, I got to go in there and do that. I've seen so many ERT teams, Debbie, from other states, from Louisiana, JD. Everywhere they're coming. I've seen the deluge of North Carolina. You have too. Tennessee. And what's happened is teams. The pride has gotten out. But I want you to stretch yourself just a minute, and then I'm going to wrap this up in just a couple of minutes. I want you to stretch yourself, and Lowry may help me at lunch find out that I'm theologically way off. I don't think I am. Because the Holy Spirit just... He brought it to me when I was doing my studies on this, and when I was looking at this, I said, you know, Micah may have said it 400 or 500 or 100 years earlier than Jesus' birth, but Jesus said this. Jesus said, if you're my disciples, then you deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. Think about it. Micah says, do justice. Jesus says, deny self. Micah says love, mercy. Jesus says take up your cross, where love and mercy was shown. And then Micah says walk humbly with God. Jesus says follow me. That's discipleship. in a nutshell. Yet we raise our chest and our chins and our head and we say, let somebody else do it. God does not want a specific type of offering. God wants a specific type of life and person. The fashion culminates in what we have as an answer. It may not be the answer that we would like and the people expected. In fact, it may not have been what they were seeking. They had focused on their offerings of children even, small and large. They had emphasized on sacrificial worship to the exclusion of justice and kindness. The people have rightly considered the nature of their offerings. And the commentators say that God's concern here is to point out what God requires is more than a sacrifice. It's entering into God's presence and His power. God clothes and clarifies this. What is good, O mortal? And the answer is very straightforward. Just do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with your God. The more difficult task is to live into these requirements. As God's people, justice is perhaps not our default operating system. Humility is not a second nature. What actions these require call forth from us a look into our own hearts and lives, and that we look into the lives of our neighbors and our community. Church. Let me ask you, will you follow Jesus with your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness? If so, respond, we will. Disciples of Jesus Christ, it's not an easy task, but it's one that produces love. And that people can come here safely and find love in action. That's a true disciple of Jesus Christ. So as we come to this place in which we examine our hearts and lives, have I really been a true disciple of Jesus Christ? Am I growing as a disciple? Come to this altar. You and God can work it out. And as we close with this hymn of faith, please take time to talk and walk humbly with God.
Turn to 172 as we sing, My Jesus, I Love Thee.
Thank you.
And Jesus said, my commands are not burdensome, so go. They may seem like requirements and expectations, and yes, they are, but don't let them be burdensome. Let them naturally flow from your life to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with your God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.